FEMA is heading to the southern border to help manage the logistical crisis of so many unaccompanied minors coming across the United States-Mexico border. Department of Homeland Security Secretary Alejandro Mayorkas asked FEMA to help receive shelter and transfer unaccompanied minors for the next 90 days. In the past year, nearly 30,000 unaccompanied minors crossed the border. Almost 3,000 were under 12. Those numbers, according to U.S. Customs and Border Protection. Tonight, we're taking a look at both sides of the issue. Joining me now, Andrew Arthur, resident fellow in law and policy for the Center for Immigration Studies. Also joining us is David Leopold, an attorney specializing in visas, citizenship, and family-based immigration. Thank you, too, for both joining us.
Thank you. Good to be here.
First to you, David, why are we seeing so many unaccompanied minors right now?
Well, we're seeing unaccompanied minors, but there's been an increase. But it's actually a small percentage of the overall increase. So it isn't any different than what you saw under the Trump administration, both in 2018 and 2019. In fact, the numbers were actually quite much higher than. The issue is not the numbers that are coming in. There's never been, ever, a slowdown or a stop in the humanity that's coming up from Central America. What's happened over the last 4 years is that the previous administration, simply gutted the system that was in place. And in particular, gutted licensed shelters. So the Biden administration is now in the unenviable position of having to pretty much rebuild from scratch and put together a system out of a decimated system by the Trump administration to accommodate, to take care of, and to make sure that these unaccompanied minors that are coming in are placed in proper homes, placed with their family members, with their parents, so that they're safe.
Andrew, do you agree?
Well, I have great respect for Mr. Leopold. Don't know him personally, but his reputation goes before him. But I do have to disagree with several of the points that he made. The Trump administration had plenty of shelter space last year, and actually they had plenty of shelter space after they pushed Congress for additional HHS shelter space in June of 2019. The president, then President Trump, faced a very similar situation to the one that President Biden did, but House Democrats sat on a funding bill for 7 weeks until they provided money for HHS shelters. I certainly understand what President Biden's doing with respect to opening temporary shelters, because the fact is those kids do not belong in Border Patrol processing centers. But the Biden administration has to address the underlying root causes of children coming to the United States, and that's because their parents are paying for smugglers to bring them here. So until the administration wakes up to that fact, this is just going to be a crisis that gets worse.
All right, Andrew, let's stick with you. There was a lot of criticism of the Trump administration for using what were called cages to hold minors. What needs to happen to handle so many minors crossing the border?
Well, and that's a very good point. Thank you for asking it. The Border Patrol processing centers and stations we have right now were built in the 80s and 90s. Mr. Leopold will tell you that back then we primarily saw single adult males from Mexico, and those facilities were built for them. Under the Obama administration, Jay Johnson erected temporary barriers to protect minor children from unrelated adult males primarily. And, you know, those barriers were created at a chain link. Unfortunately, we've seen the demographics change, but Congress just hasn't funded the money yet in order to build different centers. In 2019, a bipartisan panel called for the erection of such shelters, but the Democrats in Congress, in the last Congress, did nothing about that request.
David, I want you to respond to that. And do you think having FEMA come in to help out in this situation is a good call?
Let me start off. I'll respond, but let me start off by respectfully disagreeing on what the root causes are. I don't see any evidence, and I know that there's not going to be produced any evidence this evening that parents are somehow paying smugglers. I think that's a nice talking point for the restrictionist movement. But what's really going on is you've got a prior administration that, what did they do? They canceled legal pathways for children to apply for protection in the United States. And they cut funding to the region, to Central America, which further destabilized the situation, causing children to unaccompanied minors to come up here, and others, frankly, they dismantled, all but dismantled our asylum system in the United States, even though it's written in law that people can apply for asylum coming to the United States, regardless of how they get here, whether they get here legally or whether they cross the border in between checkpoints. What else did they do? They separated children from their parents, effectively kidnapping them at the border. It was just a onslaught of cruelty over the last 4 years. And so we want to talk about root causes. The root causes have never been dealt with. In fact, the Trump administration stopped funding for the Central American Minors Program. And that was something that was started by the Obama administration. That program is designed so that minors can apply for protection regionally so that they don't have to get into this very dangerous trek up to the United States. There's been no effort by the Trump, was no effort by the previous administration to get to the root causes. In fact, what did they do? They spent a lot of money on a useless border wall, and they also diverted money from our military. So we can talk root causes. The Biden administration, in the first few weeks of its existence, is already issued an executive order talking about root causes. So these are important issues. You know, this I think what's important to remember here is that the flow of humanity up from Central America is not a Biden phenomenon. This has been going on for years. And in fact, the flow of refugees to America is an American phenomenon. That's what this country is about. My dad, you know, escaped the Holocaust. That's how I got here. My family got here. This is as American as it gets. And so, you know, we're also a country, when we talk about several hundred thousand people or tens of thousands of unaccompanied minors, look, this country put out a vaccine in record time to combat COVID. We put people on the moon. We've done other incredible things. This country is incredible. We can certainly solve the problem of a few hundred thousand people coming up from Central America. We just have to get to that issue. And that's not blaming, you know, immigrants for their own, immigrants in the United States and slandering them by saying they're paying smugglers. That's getting to the real.
If I could respond to that point very briefly, Judge Andrew Hannon, when he was prosecuting his fourth smuggler in a month, actually made exactly that same point, that the parents were paying the smugglers to bring the children to the United States. Mr. Leopold plainly knows of this decision because it was well publicized. And Hannon, Judge Hannon, questioned why the parents themselves weren't being prosecuted. Yeah. In essence, what the Biden administration wants to do is deliver those children to the parents who paid the smugglers. 78.7% of all sponsors of children in the United States are here illegally. Plainly, probably Mr. Leopold knows that as well, because the House or the Senate Government Affairs Committee made exactly that finding. So truly, we are talking about humanity. Truly, we need to care for children. But the Biden plan is to pump billions of dollars into Latin America. And I was a judge. I've heard hundreds, if not thousands, of Central American cases. And generally, those cases all are based on the premise that the governments of those countries are corrupt. If you give money to a corrupt country, you're not going to make anything any better. And if you steal the youth of those countries and bring them into the United States, they're not going to have a future. You don't have to believe me on that. The Guatemalan Minister of Governance made exactly that same point 2 years ago.
Gentlemen, we need to stop it here. We're running out of time. Andrew, Arthur, David Leopold, we appreciate your time on such an important issue.
Thank you.